the dean of the School of Health Physical Education, Health Physical Education, which is really kinesiology and recreation. I'm going to speak very briefly and talk about the rest of the story at the end, where we're going from here. We have a very distinguished guest with us today, and I just want to recognize Francis Soto. If you just stand, Francis. Francis is the head of the preservation unit, the archaeological preservation unit for the Dominican Republic government. He's been very responsible for the exhibit that you're going to see, and also for the wonderful relationship we at IU have had with the Dominican Republic for well over 20 years. If it weren't for Francis's trust in the work that we do, none of it would have gotten done. So Francis, thank you, and thank you for coming in. I'm going to introduce two or three people I want to recognize. One is Mr. Charles Beaver, who's the director of our underwater archaeology program in Piper. He and Francis have worked together for well over 20 years. I'm a new dean. I've been here for about 7 months, and I had to, of course, go down to the Dominican Republic and see for myself, because when somebody says they're spending all their time in the Caribbean doing diving for, for a godly country, you have to go down and see for yourself. And I was just absolutely blown away and amazed. Also, Charles Beaker's collaborator of many years is Dr. Jeff Conrad, who will be speaking first. Dr. Conrad is the director of the Mathers Museum. He's an expert on Taino art and culture, which you'll be hearing about tonight. And he's also a professor in the Department of Archaeology. Also, I'd be remiss not to mention Kathy Larson, if you would just stand, Kathy, who is my partner in conspiracy. She's the associate dean of the college, and also went with us recently to the Dominican Republic, where we met with the Minister of Culture, Ministers of Public Health, the director, the president of the university, and I'll speak a little more about that again. We're going to have a reception after this. But I don't want to waste any more time, so it's better that you listen to them than to me. And so I'm going to introduce Dr. Conrad. Thank you.
Thank you, Bob. Just want to make sure all the microphones are working. That one's off, this one's on, here we go. Oops. Okay, the first part of our title, and that's really my part, is Columbus and the Taino. If you count from my first season in the field, first season doing archaeological field work, I've been an archaeologist for 42 years. I've worked in some pretty high-profile places like Peru. I love the Taino, but everybody wants, I have not, in 42 years, I have never had seen a public reaction like the reaction to Captain Kidd. It's just amazing the extent to which this has captured the public imagination. But I didn't set out to work on Captain Kidd a year ago. I didn't know he was going to enter my life, much less take it over. What I want to talk about is the work that really got us to the Dominican Republic in the first place, which is the study of early interactions between Europeans and Taino, the generic term for the native people of the larger Caribbean islands in the Bahamas. If you look at human history and look at sort of transformative processes or anything, what are the 8, 10, pick any number, things that really changed the world and the way we live in it. On that list, you have to include the unification of the old and new worlds into a single world. You can't leave it off. It's one of the, once that happens, then globally, people, plants, animals, diseases, ideas start to move, change everything for everybody. And it's my privilege to actually be able to study that firsthand. In the place where it really all begins, on the island of Hispaniola, the eastern two-thirds of which are today's Dominican Republic. We have sort of two places where we've been working, down in the southeast here, and we'll get back there, because that's Captain Kidd. But I'm going to talk a little bit about our work up on the north coast, in the vicinity of a place called La Isabela, which was the first Spanish town in the Americas, founded by Columbus in 1494, and more or less abandoned by the end of 1498. Working around La Isabela, there's three things to study. There's the ruins of the Spanish town itself. We don't do that. That's been done previously. Native Taino sites in the vicinity of the Spanish town. That's my part of it. And Charlie's part, the shipwrecks in Isabela Bay. La Isabela itself, I said, it's not a focus of my particular fieldwork, but I can't not, you know, I shouldn't ignore it. This is a reconstruction of the Spanish town. That's the powder house, the customs house warehouse, upper class housing, church. That's Columbus's house, and this is where the bulk of the population lived, probably in a fairly Taino way. Just to show it's real, that's what's left of Columbus's house under a protective roof. That's a reconstruction, just to show you that the place is real, and that helps to me make the events that happened in and around it real. Customs house, biggest building. Moving on to what I particularly am doing, I am looking at the native Taino sites around La Isabela. And you know, these are the people to bear the first sustained continuous interactions with Europeans. These are the people who first feel the brunt of the unification of the old and new worlds. And what goes on out here on Hispaniola eventually gets transferred to Mexico and Peru and the rest of the Spanish Americas. First, you got to find sites before you can do anything else. So reconnaissance, survey, looking for sites is part of what we do. This was a promising looking place that didn't produce anything, wasn't a site. This is a promising looking place that did. There's a good classic, but somewhat dirty piece of Taino pottery. So you begin to build up an idea of the distribution of sites, where people were living across the landscape. And then you pick the ones, you can't excavate them all, so you pick the ones that you think are mostly going to give you the most insight into the questions that you're asking. Along this ridge, which is the first ridge back of, you can see the Isabela Bay there in the background, there's a site called El Tamarindo. We've conducted excavations there twice, most recently last summer, because it's produced data that are important for our purposes. Just a shot of the excavations. Chris Bontrager here is in the audience. Jenny Riley, I don't know if Jenny's there, but another one of our students who has worked on this. And it's just broken pieces of pottery. It's not real glamorous, you know. It's dirt and broken pieces of pottery and.